private lending versus income property. Not sure if you've done one or two, or maybe you've done both. Actually, do me a favor, comment below with, on whatever platform you're watching. I would love to know if you agree with this, disagree with this, or you might have a lot of experience with doing both. But if you have not done either or, and maybe you're considering, hey, look, I have $100,000, should I put it in private lending or should I put it in an income property? This is not for everyone, but this is my take on it, my opinion on it. $100,000 goes into a private lending deal. The return is based on the investment of $100,000. Very passive, because all you're doing is lending somebody the $100,000 for them to use for a down payment, second mortgage, but your return of 8 to 10% is based on the $100,000. That, for me, is a disadvantage, I guess. Why? Because on an income property, when you invest the $100,000, the neat thing is your return, because of the word leverage. And Dre, maybe put a little a graphic in here, because the word leverage is so important. You're gonna get a mortgage for, let's say the property is $500,000. You're gonna invest the $100,000 on this income property. You're gonna get a mortgage for $400,000, but your return now is based on the purchase price of $500,000. So when the property appreciates by, say, let's just use ultra conservative numbers of 5%, it's not 5% based on the $100,000, guys. It's 5% based on that $500,000 purchase price. So now your investment, your return is $25,000. Just some food for thought. Tell me your comments, tell me your thoughts, give me your feedback. Drop it below. If you're here somewhere, I don't know where it is, what platform you're watching. Love the support. Thanks.